Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop Elements tutorial, we'll be taking the Photoshop Elements Scene Cleaner, which will let us take some pictures like this with people in them, and clean that up to give us a nice clean shot like this over here on the right-hand side. To learn everything about working with Photoshop Elements, take a look at my complete training course. There's a link right down there in the description. And of course, don't forget to like this video and share and subscribe if you haven't already. And you can also support this channel through Patreon, and there's a link for that in the description as well. Okay, let's get to it. To use the Photoshop Elements Scene Cleaner, you need a series of pictures. Now I have five pictures down here, and they're all basically like this. If you notice, if you look at the palm trees in here, it's a handheld shot. I wasn't using this on a tripod, although a tripod would have been better. Obviously, the better your pictures, the better your results are going to be. But clean handheld will work as well. And you want them to be all basically at the same position. Notice that the rocks are a little different over here from down here. There's a little more showing down below here than there is up here, a little less showing down here than down here. So it's not exactly the same shot, but they're basically the same shot. Now, that's what you need for the scene cleaner. Let's take a look at that down here. Now, I had actually planned on using the scene cleaner for this series of images just because I wanted a nice clean shot of this, and there were a lot of people walking around, and I knew that I could use the scene cleaner if I had enough open spots in enough pictures. For instance, over here, this spot is clean. It's not clean right there. This spot is clean in here, and on this one up here, we have a clean spot over here without a clean spot there. So I have different areas that were clean. That's the whole idea here, is take several pictures and try to get throughout all of those pictures everything clean at least once in your pictures. Okay, let's go over here to the guided edits. I normally don't work with the guided edits. I really don't like these most of the time, but I do like a lot of the photo merge stuff, and I like the scene cleaner here quite a bit. Let's go ahead and we'll start this up. Now you can choose from 2 to 10 photos down there in your photo bin. I have 5. I don't necessarily need all of these, but I'll go ahead and load all 5 anyway. I'll just click on open all. We'll then launch the scene cleaner, and it gives you this basic setup. This is just the first picture right down there being displayed. What you want to do is to choose what you want as your basic picture and put that over here, kind of your base picture. I think this one right down here looks pretty good. Not that many people in it. Nice composition and so forth. So I'm just going to take this and drag it up here into this right-hand location. Now it's a little bit off. Notice how that Photoshop Elements has come in and adjusted the perspective for me, and it's a little bit off. So this really isn't as good as, say, this picture is over here on the left-hand side. So let's use this one instead. And that's this first one. I'll put that over there. That's better. It's a little straighter, and it's a little better perspective on that. So this would be the base picture. And then simply choose a picture you want to work from. Now in here I have this person here and this person here kind of in the way. So I want to find a picture here where it's clean in this area. And I think this one right here looks pretty good. Just click on that area. And then you can use a pencil tool and an eraser tool. You probably should have show strokes selected. And let's grab the pencil tool. You can adjust the size of the pencil if you need to. I've never actually had a reason to change that. What you do is you go over here to your source picture and draw a shape around the clean part that you want to copy over to here. It looks like she is right below that column, so there's that column right there. And he's about center, so I want this area right in here. So I'll start right here, and I'll do a little shape just kind of like that. And then Elements takes this and blends this in over here, and that's a nice clean shot. So we've picked up these two people right there, but this spot's been cleaned up. Okay, so far so good. Let's now find something where it's clean. We have two people over here. We don't have those, so they're okay. But we have these two people in here, so I want a shot where it's clean in that area. Let's see what we've got over here. I'll click on this one, and that's clean in that area right in there. Okay, so let's go ahead and, using the same pencil tool, I'll come in and I'll draw a shape right around in this area here. And it grabs this, brings it in over here. You can see there's the shapes. If I roll off, they're gone. Come back in again. That's what it's copied in. And that's all we needed. That actually cleaned out that whole area down here, so that's nice and clean. Okay, I think that looks good. You can see how easy it is to use. The important thing, of course, is you need to be able to find clean spots in your set of pictures to be able to replace the spots that have people in them. And again, if your camera is basically in the same position looking at basically the same scene, and you get enough shots, you should be able to find some clean spots in there so you can remove the people. Okay, that has been taken care of now. There are some more options. We have an eraser tool. You can erase back into this. If you take out too much, you can try to use this to adjust your selection, but it's usually pretty good. You can show the strokes or not. There it is. You can show regions or not. That's the regions in there. You can see there's the region right there that was taken from. I normally have mine just at show strokes. And there's some advanced options down here, an alignment tool, but it did an automatic alignment pretty well. I've never actually even had to come in here and adjust this, so occasionally useful. This is more useful if you're not as clean on your pictures. If you are actually moving your camera around a bit much, you may be able to use these advanced options in here to help you align the picture better. But again, if you think about this and you know you have people in your shot, you can go ahead and take the time, try to make nice clean shots. Just pick a spot right in the middle of your picture and keep that in the middle of your picture and take a few shots as people walk through, and then you should be able to have a nice set of images giving you those clean spots that you need. Okay, so that part is done. Let's now move on to the next, right down here, bottom right hand corner. We're still in guided edit. As you can see, we can take a look at this and it looks nice and clean. A little bit right there is a sign that's actually there, so that's fine. Okay, good and clean. Once we're here, we have some options. You can share it on Facebook or Flickr or Twitter. You can save it or save as, or you can continue editing. Obviously, we have one last problem left, actually two problems. One is that the picture isn't fitting our whole size. And right down here, there's some weird stuff happening right in that area there. So we need to crop in a little bit on our picture. So we'll do that over in expert mode. Click expert mode, and then right up here, let's see if we can get these things out of our way. All these examples I had up, just minimize those. And there we go, there is the final shot. Let's just refit this to screen, and there it is. Okay, nice and clean. There's the original we started off with right there, and here's our clean view. Nice, good image. Okay, I want to crop in a little bit in here, and use it to clean up this side stuff and get rid of a little bit of a problem right down there. So let's switch to the crop tool, which is right over here. With the crop tool, you have lots of choices in here, different ratios. I'm going to go ahead and choose the 4:6 ratio, and you can see the grid in there. Then simply move this grid around until it's on your shot and then fits nicely. Now, this is a little bit too small for the picture, so I'm going to stretch this out about as far as I can, right to that edge and right to that edge. And right here I wanted to hide that bit, so I'll bring it just above that little weird bit and make sure I'm staying inside the picture left and right. Get a little bit of palm tree here and there, that looks good. So there we go, there's our nice cropping. Click on the green check mark, let it finish off our picture, and there it is. There's our nice clean shot without people walking all the way through, all done quickly and easily with that scene cleaner over there in the guided edit. Let me just show you where that is again. It's in the photo merge section right here, guided, photo merge, and photo merge scene cleaner. And allows you to do neat stuff if you have enough of these pictures with different choices of people walking around, but clean areas that you need. You can then clean up a shot like this and give you that. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button and, of course, share. Just click on share and share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Think about supporting this channel through Patreon. There's a link for that in the description. And to learn a whole lot more about how to use the Photoshop Elements program, take a look at my complete training courses. There's a link right down there in the description. And I have different courses for each different version of Photoshop Elements.